Balle au centre. Des 10 heures pour 90 minutes de jeu. Balle au centre, c'est votre nouveau rendez-vous de tous les sports sur votre télé. Plus de scoops, d'actualité, de reportages, plus de commentaires, les insights de toutes les fédérations, portraits de légende.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for joining us for another edition of the 6 p.m. English News over the Republican Television. Let's begin with our headlines. The official mascot of 2021 AFCON has rounded his official tour in the city of Bamenda, welcoming Mola and hundreds of the Bamenda city dwellers who, even though the region will not host any pool of the tournament, have requested the construction of a stadium in Bamenda. Those were our headlines. Details in a bit. Welcome back. The Catholic University of Central Africa in Yaoundé has celebrated its 30 years of existence, coupled with the award of 11 medals to personnel for their own tireless efforts to upload the image of the university. The ceremony was presided over by the Minister of Higher Education in the school campus this December 16, 2021. And Umeko was present. Her report.
Glorious song to grace the 2021 Award of Labor Medals to personnels of the Catholic University of Central Africa. His Lordship Jean Barga, awarded National Officer of Valor, six other personnels received a National Knight Valor Medals, and 18 others National Order of Cameroon Merit. A historic 30th anniversary to reward hard work.
Head of State is very glad, is very satisfied by what they are doing here in this fantastic university. I have also given medals for the Grand Chancellor of this university, the Archbishop Jean Barga, and for the Rector of this university, and for staff personnel of this great university, for what they are doing here in this very important university. Head of state is very satisfied, and I am also very glad.
Medals of valor come in as motivation to work harder.
After 30 years, we did a great job, a very important expertise, and I want to congratulate all my collaborators. After 30 years, we can say we got a great experience to continue better in the future. So that I can say to the families and all the nations in Africa to continue to give to us confidence, because we are very, very motivated to continue this service for the youth and for our all continent in Africa.
Undiluted joy is visible after receiving meritorious medals.
I'm so grateful, and words are not really flowing. See, having so many years of work, hard working, and today receiving a medal, this is an exception. This is an exceptional medal. You see, you cannot even guess during your career that you will have such medals. So I'm so very grateful to the head of state, the rector, and the archbishop. This is my joy is so high.
Celebrating 30th anniversary of the Catholic University of Central Africa in Yaoundé, an award of medals to personnels who brave odds to uplift the image of the institution, presided by the Minister of Higher Education under the theme, State, Religious Societies in Black Africa, Crossed Analysis, December 16, 2021.
The Minister of Territorial Administration, Paul Atanganji, has reiterated the need for peace, living together and coexistence in the Logon and Share division of the north at the far north region of Cameroon. The head of the interministerial delegation dispatched by the head of state was speaking yesterday at the Kusiri ceremonial ground, where he handed over presidential relief materials to the victims of the Mugum and Arab Shoah conflict. We have details with Bertrand Tita.
The head of the interministerial mission dispatched by His Excellency Paul Biya to Logon and Share division of the far north region was headed by the Minister of Territorial Administration, Paul Atanganji. His message of peace, reconciliation and living together to the belligerent communities of Mugum and Arab Shoah. The dispatch of the fact-finding and reconciliation mission by the head of state came on the heels of intertribal clashes between the two communities that erupted on December 8, 2021, leading to the loss of lives, destructions, looting of private and public properties. The envoy of the head of state while conveying the sincere condolences of the presidential couple to the bereaved families and wishing quick recovery to the injured, called on the belligerent communities to bury their hatred and embrace peace, which are tenets of the head of state. Paul Atanganji called on both political and religious leaders to embrace peace and preach to their various communities the virtues of peace and peaceful cohabitation. Honorable Kamsulum Abba Kabi, who spoke on behalf of the Arabkoa population, called on the state to do a proper investigation of the root causes of the intermittent clashes between the two communities and other sister communities that have to cohabit in the same environment and share the same natural resources. He said only such sincere efforts can seek lasting solutions to the problems that are an economy which is on a downturn due to the Boko Haram insurgency. On his part, Colonel Ahmad Karkaba Marbum, speaking on behalf of the Mugum community, appreciated the effort of the government in stepping in at the right moment to separate the two communities that were on each other's throat. He called on all to embrace peace because there can be no meaningful development without peace. He said what is paramount now is forgiveness of the past and to forge ahead as one people. The interministerial delegation led by Paul Atanganji had as members the Secretary of State in the Ministry of Defense in charge of the Gendarmerie, Landry Galax Etoga, the Secretary General of the Ministry of Defense and the Secretary General in the General Delegation of National Security. According to statistics, about 17,534 people have been affected by the clashes spanning from Logon and Share through Mayo Dani Jamare Division. Statistics from officials of the Cameroon Embassy in Chad also reveals that about 39,000 flee the conflict and are living in Chad as refugees. Minister Paul Atanganji did not move to the far north region empty-handed, as he brought along humanitarian assistance to the affected population. The relief packages consisted of blankets, mattresses, buckets, bathing soaps, rice and vegetable oil. The same assistance will be taken to those living in Chad as refugees.
We continue with that story to say, after holding peace talks with the authorities of Logon and Share division of the far north region, Minister Paul Atanganji expatiated on the need for peace to return and possible ways to ensure to solve dispute. We have let's listen to the minister in an excerpt carefully selected by Bertrand Tita.
Nous avons enregistré ce que les gens ont dit, il y aura des solutions, bien évidemment, et nous allons faire des rapports au chef de l'État et il donnera des orientations à qui il faut. Je crois que c'est un problème essentiellement entre les éleveurs et les agriculteurs, mais on peut trouver des solutions, c'est pas ça qui peut donner lieu à des tueries. à des incendies, à des scènes de pillage. Et il y a des enfants qui ont été assassinés, il y a des adultes qui ont été assassinés, il y a des personnes qui ont été violentées, il y a des boutiques, des marchés incendiés. Je crois que ce n'est pas des choses très correctes. Donc nous disons à tout le monde, nous avons interpellé les chefs de communauté, les autorités religieuses, les imams, les autorités politiques, les élites, et tout le monde doit jouer sa partie. Et si nous sommes tous sincères pour mettre un terme à cette affaire-là, on a été d'accord. Il faut que les gens soient sincères. Donc j'ai dit, le vivre ensemble ne doit pas seulement être un mot, c'est un comportement. J'ai dit que la paix ne doit pas seulement être un mot, c'est un comportement. Et quand le chef d'État parle de maintien de la paix, c'est parce que le chef d'État, son excellence, est d'abord un grand apporteur de la paix. Qui, quelle que soit la circonstance, essaie de gérer les crises avec beaucoup de pondération. Et les événements lui ont toujours donné raison. Donc c'est pour ça que c'est une mission très importante. Et je crois que les communautés doivent se sentir heureuses, n'est-ce pas, de cette mission. Et nous allons faire de notre mieux, n'est-ce pas, pour transmettre le message fidèlement.
The Minister of Transport, Jean-Ernest Masenangale Bibihe, has this Thursday, December 16th, presided over a restoration meeting on the pilot phase of the digital movement of passengers and merchandise, a project presented for validation by Camtrak MTN Group for the prevention of road accidents in the country. We have details in the following report.
Setting up a new intelligent and proactive system which combines the management of the factors at the origin of road accidents is the objective of the phase of the centralized project for interurban transportation as part of the public-private partnership between the Ministry of Transport and the Camtrak MTN Group. This restoration meeting, attended by promoters of transport companies, was to address risk factors and outlined some of the advantages of the intelligent system which can help reduce road accidents.
The first observation we have noticed is that we have 400 vehicles, 100 interurban mass transport company, transportation companies of persons, and 300 vehicles of dangerous merchandise. They were equipped with a highly sophisticated intelligent system that combines the management of the risk factors of accidents, which is the human factor with 70%, the road, the infrastructure, which is 10%, and the vehicle itself, which is 20%.
Haven't evaluated this system for 2 months now, the Minister of Transport appreciates the solution and has extended with the legal framework of the system to be put in place.
With the legal framework of this system being put in place right now, there is going to be an order for an extension of this system to all the interurban mass transportation companies, including vehicles that transport merchandise, because human life has no price, and we have to make sure that we reduce, using this intelligent artificial intelligence, reduce accidents to zero.
Most transport promoters, though appreciated the initiative, are however not satisfied with the percentage required to be paid by transportation companies.
The project is a very good project, but now the problem is that is the cost of the project, because they say it will cost 60,000 for one bus a month. Transporters say the is too much for them, because they have too much charges. And that is the problem, that they could not speak here, because the Minister of Transport, as a unionist, we had many meetings with them. Those meetings, they told what they are thinking. So now the problem is that they said that we shall meet a new meeting, so we shall make a proposition to the Minister of Transport, so that the prices that are put should be looked down.
With this new system, according to the Minister of Transport, road accidents will be reduced to its simplest expression in the country.
Still in that story, the Director of Road Transport further explains how this new intelligent system will be used in order to attain the objective of zero accidents on our roads. Let's take a listen.
This sophisticated intelligence system has combined in a proactive manner to identify all the risk factors and address these risk factors before accidents occur. We have more than 18,000 risk factors for 400 vehicles within less than 2 months that this system has been able to address and got to book those vehicles and avoided accident scenarios. We have seen situations where you have vehicles that were being driven by drivers that were practically sleeping while driving about 70% aboard this vehicle. Imagine the circumstances if the system was not there to signal to the driver that the driver is sleeping and immobilize that vehicle to avoid accidents. We have today an intelligent system to manage the movement of persons in a proactive manner to avoid road accidents, which has been installed in these 400 vehicles. Within the period of 2 months, we have not registered any accident, despite the fact that we have had about 18,000 accident risk factors that those vehicles have performed. But the system was able to contain the risk factors, particularly excessive speed, that we have more than 9,000 cases of excessive speed. Once the vehicle is being plied at excessive speed, the system sends a signal and reduces the speed automatically and call the vehicle to book to make sure that we don't have an accident. 2 months, 400 vehicles checked intelligently, zero accidents.
Let's now talk health, where ahead of the AFCON 2021 that Cameroon looks forward to host in the days ahead, Minister Manaudu Malachi of Public Health and his counterpart of sports, Narcisse Moelle Combi, today granted a joint press briefing to assure national and international opinion on the measures taken by the country to ensure a COVID-free AFCON ahead of the competition to run from January 9th to February 6th, 2022. Minister Manaudu Malachi, during the press briefing, disclosed some measures ranking from the training of health experts to the acquisition of new ambulances to ensure the health of players, official delegations, and spectators during the event, while outlining the various conditions for all to have access to major fields in the country. Let's now take a listen to an excerpt of the public health boss, carefully selected by Dan Ninkam.
Like a year ago, during another continental competition, the African National Championship, we were faced with several challenges. Not only the successful organization of this important event, but also the health coverage of the competition in the context of pandemic of COVID-19. It should be remembered that this competition was perfectly mastered health-wise. However, with the experience gained, we want to take additional measures to provide participating athletes with all the necessary health security during the AFCON that Cameroon will be hosting in the coming days. Gentlemen, thus presented, it is the health pass for the AFCON Total Energy Cameroon 2021. Any person who will be inside the stadium shall be either fully vaccinated or have a negative antigen test of less than 24 hours. The strict control of this health pass shall be ensured to guarantee first and foremost the health safety of athletes and officials and enable the public from all participating countries to experience an exceptional and unprecedented event which Cameroon, a country whose position in the world football is indisputable, is preparing to host under the enlightened leadership of His Excellency Paul Biya, Head of State. Cameroon is therefore ready for a COVID-19 free AFCON.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching the 6 p.m. English News over Kamdi's Television. Let's now talk sport, where the official mascot of 2021 AFCON has rounded his official tour in the city of Bamenda, welcoming Mola and hundreds of the Bamenda city dwellers who, even though the region will not host any pool of the tournament, have requested the construction of a stadium in Bamenda. We have more of this story with Bertrand Tita.
They came out, they saw it, and they are happy. The official mascot of the African Cup of Nations tournament, Mola, has toured some major parts of the city of Bamenda, chief town of the northwest region of Cameroon. From the governor's junction, where the delegation was welcomed by the secretary of the governor's office, who said despite the fact that the region will not be part of the cities hosting the tournament, it was needful for the people to experience how the mascot looks like.
The team that has come from Yaoundé to accompany the mascot of the AFCON to the northwest region. We want to welcome that team, and we want to say that we are very happy to welcome our mascot, Mola. Mola, you are welcome to Bamenda. We are very happy. I want to say we are delighted to receive that mascot here in Bamenda. We were surprised to hear that the mascot is coming to Bamenda. And you can understand the reason why we were surprised. It is because, as you know, our region does not have a pool for the AFCON. So we were waiting to...
Mola moved from Bamenda up station down to Finance Junction, Mobile Nkwen, Cow Street, Sonak Street, and City Chemist Roundabout. At the Commercial Avenue, Mola had a work while displaying what they brought for the population of the Northwest region.
I want to say to you, Mola, welcome. And above and beyond, we want to say that it's called
Togo.
Everybody, it's called what?
Togo.
Can we say Togo welcome?
Togo welcome.
Today is a blessing to be Bamenda, to see Mola in Bamenda. I didn't know Mola could stroll freely like this in Bamenda. What do you plan to watch?
I mean, Mola coming to the region, I think it is like, you know, bringing the AFCON to the region so that the people too can feel Mola, they can also see Mola. You know, many of us, we've been seeing Mola on TV, we've never seen Mola live. So coming to the region, I think it's a laudable initiative. And I mean, you saw people coming out even though the euphoria was not really there, but at least they will have a story to tell tomorrow that in 2021, when Cameroon was about to host AFCON, they were among those who actually saw Mola live.
On the bad roads and no football stadium in Bamenda, the people have asked Mola to express their worries to the Yaoundé government. From Commercial Avenue, the Mola moved through the Old Town neighborhood, then the Ayaba Street, and back to the Governor's Junction, where they say goodbye from Bamenda.
The handball Lionesses of Cameroon are set to return to the country after taking part in the 25th edition of the Senior Women's Handball World Cup in Spain. From their balance sheet, Cameroon played 7 games and won 2, but the girls of Serge Kwebengo won 5 individual distinctions as player of the match during the competition. We have details with Isaac Ngonkum.
The group stage of the 25th edition of the Senior Women's Handball World Cup, currently taking place in Spain, was not an easy ride for Cameroon. In 3 outings, the girls of coach Serge Christian Gwebogo failed to win even a single game, losing to Russia, Serbia, and Poland. The girls are now focused on improving on their world ranking.
We are filled with mixed feelings because we didn't fully achieve our objectives, with all the reasons you can imagine. Well, I'm also happy because we leave the World Cup with 2 wins. Another big positive is the impressive number of Player of the Match awards that we garnered here in Spain. For the first time, Cameroon won 5 of such distinctions. Coach Serge Guebogo expressed mixed feelings after their last defeat to Poland yesterday. At one time in the competition, we were handicapped with 4 players leaving the den. We continue to fight as lionesses. That's something positive. The fighting spirit was constant all along the road, even when the adversary was very intense. It's very important for the future. The Cameroon team, despite falling back to the President's Cup, wasn't ridiculous as 2 players emerged player of the match in the group stage. We just need adequate means and better organization for better results in future competitions. It is hoped the Handball Lionesses will win the President's Cup and better prepare for the 2022 Handball AFCON in Senegal next year.
FAB Men's Basketball Club of Yaoundé have sealed their ticket for the second edition of the Basketball African League built for 2022. The boys of Francois Eyengue picked up the qualification ticket yesterday after beating BS Espoir Focash in the semi-finals at the Yaoundé Multipurpose Sports Complex in Yaoundé. We have details with Isaac Ngonkom.
It is a done deal. FAB Men's Basketball Club of Yaoundé are through to the final stage of the second edition of the Basketball Africa League BAL 2022 by beating BC Espoir Focash of the Democratic Republic of Congo by 70 points to 56 yesterday at the semi-finals. The boys of Francois Eyengue have written their names on the history books of the elite basketball tournament with a second consecutive qualification. They are currently taking on Slack of Guinea at the Yaoundé Multipurpose Sports Complex in the West Division final of the qualification tournament. Slack also booked a historical ticket for next year's Basketball Africa League after emerging victorious over AS Please by 81 points to 78. Tonight's final is therefore a simple formality as both teams are already through to the main competition. But FAB of Yaoundé will certainly be looking forward to making a 100% win competition a moral booster for the main tournament that is jointly sponsored by the American National Basketball Association, the NBA, and the International Basketball Federation, FIBA.
Still in our sports page, football lovers on the African continent have been foaming with anger over a letter written by the European Clubs Association to CAF and FIFA. In the famous letter, the ECA claims they can't release their players to play with their national selections during the 2021 Africa Cup of Nations in Cameroon due to fears of COVID. In the following report, our reporter Isaac Ngonkum frowns at such a degrading attitude from the European Clubs Association and says it's high time CAF and FIFA rose up to their responsibilities. His report.
It all began like a joke some weeks back when Liverpool coach Jurgen Klopp hinted that in January, a certain small competition would be played in Africa. He was referring to the 2021 Africa Cup of Nations that will be staged in Cameroon in January and February next year, bringing together 24 nations. It is exactly this white domination mentality that prompted the European Clubs Association to pen a letter to the Confederation of African Football, CAF, and the World Football Governing Body, FIFA, this Wednesday, 15th December 2021, indicating their unwillingness to let players of African origin participate in the football fiesta if the official excuse is the rapid spread of the coronavirus pandemic and fears that the Confederation of African Football, CAF, has not taken adequate measures to ensure a strict medical protocol that will keep the foreign-based players in good health throughout the football bonanza. African football lovers know very well that their problem is elsewhere. If not, How can we explain the irony that the European continent has recorded the highest number of COVID-19 infections, deaths and hospitalizations, yet football stadia continue to be filled with spectators every week? The 2020 European Nations Cup that recently took place is another glaring example of how these European clubs take Africans as fools. Enough is enough. It is high time FIFA and CAF take their responsibilities seriously and stop this European diktat on African football. It is not the first time European clubs are hesitating to release African players playing their professional football on their continent to participate in the AFCON. It is an open secret that the European clubs will be badly affected by the African Cup of Nations in January and February next year. Players like Mohamed Salah, Sadio Mane and Naby Keita will be greatly missed by Liverpool supporters. The same thing applies for Riyad Mahrez and Edouard Mendy, who play for Manchester City and Chelsea Football Club respectively, without making the list exhaustive. Yes, there is a high need for all stakeholders to put their heads together and come out with a win-win solution for both club and national selections. But sacrificing the 2021 Africa Cup of Nations in order to satisfy the selfish interest of European football clubs is simply unacceptable. The reaction of CAF and FIFA on this scandal is highly expected. Somebody must tell these white supremacists, let our African players go. No to African football marginalization. No. No, no.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of our 6 p.m. English news over the Republican Television. Desiree Trezor Bonnet will be yours at exactly 8 p.m. for news in the French language. But until then, do stay glued in the company of interesting programs over Camdis Television. Thanks for watching.